Alright, what we got here is we got a car that had some damage on the front end of it. Now, when I fixed the damage on the front end, the owner also requested that I go ahead and paint the front end of the car because of the rock chips and the small minor imperfections that are used from everyday use of driving your car. So I said, no problem. Now we had a dent over here, so I went ahead and fixed that dent. And then over here, it had some kind of blemish in it. And I went ahead and sanded that out and reprimed it. And then, of course, it had all the rock chips and imperfections on the front end of it. And I went ahead and sanded that down and primed it. So what we got here, we got three full wet coats of 2K primer that's been applied to the car. I went ahead and put a guide coat on it. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and sand this down ready for paint. But the real kicker is I'm going to show you how to do it fast, simple, and easy to save you a lot of time and a lot of money.
Welcome to DIY Automotive School with my friend Pete and Minnie, the body shop girl. It's everything you need to know about cars and more.
So if we look the car over, you can see that the primer was sprayed on top of the paint. Now what I did is I sanded a bigger space than what I was going to prime. And the reason I did that is because I don't want my primer to go onto the shiny paint that I didn't sand, because what will happen, it'll flake. When I start sanding, it'll start flaking off and peeling instead of feathering out like we want. Another thing that I did, if you notice, I went ahead and taped off the whole hood, basically. And the reason I did that is because I don't want tape lines, like when I pull the tape off here, watch what happens. Let's see if I can get a hold of that. And you can see right there, there's a tape line right there. So what I'll have to do is when that tape line's there, I'll have to get rid of that tape line and feather that out. So when we spray our primer like this in an open area and let it just blend its way around, it's a lot easier to sand. And it's a lot quicker and you use less sandpaper. We're going to go ahead and cover this fender back up because we don't want to scratch that fender. Even though we're going to go ahead and paint the whole front cap of this vehicle, I still don't want to sand that down. But now that we have applied our primer the proper way, the next thing that we want to do is we want to sand that down, feather it out, and prep it up for paint. And what's going to save us a lot of time and a lot of money, and the reason I say money is because we're going to use less sandpaper to do it the way that I'm going to show you, is we're going to go ahead and use a DA sander to break our primer down and to feather everything out before we hand sand it. And on this particular vehicle, we're going to wet sand this because this is actually a single stage paint that's on here, and we're going to be doing base coat, clear coat on top of that. But the situation is I want to make sure that this is sanded properly, and I always wet sand this type of vehicle instead of dry sand it, especially when we are painting the whole front nose and we're not going to paint the rest of it. We got to be able to sand that properly. But before we do that, what's going to save us a lot of time and money is we're going to use our DA sander. And you can see I got two DA sanders sitting here, and I'm going to show you which one to use and which one not to use. And we're going to use that sander to bust the primer down and get it ready for wet sanding. So if we look at our sanders right here, you can see one is different than the other. This one here is called a short throw palm sander. And what this is a finished sander. This is the sander that we will be using. And the reason it's called a short throw is because when you look at the sander itself, all right, the throw of it, this is called dual action. It actually spins like this. And then it also moves like that. But the throw of this is about half the throw of a conventional DA sander, which is this, and this is not a finished sander. This sander is used for doing your body work, roughing everything in, and doing everything besides finishing. And this is the sander that I used when I started this job. I took this sander right here before I primed it, and I did all the work that I had to do on it using this sander here. But on this particular job, we are going to use the palm sander, which is our short throw finish sander, to go ahead and prep up our hood for paint. So what I've applied to the sander itself is I went ahead and put 180, you can see that, and that's what we want to start out with. Using our short throw sander, it's going to give us a fine finish instead of a rough finish, because we won't be able to see the swirls as bad. Once again, I'm going to go ahead and say it again, I'm going to hand sand this before I paint it, and it will also give us the ability to feather all the primer out without removing it all off the vehicle. So we're going to plug our sander in. Now, one other thing I want to tell you is the variable speed, and let me show you what we're talking about. That's on high, and then of course, that's low. When you do a job like this, and you're feathering the primer out, and you're busting it down so you can hand sand it, you always want to be in the middle. So let's go ahead and adjust that sander. There we go, right there. So I got it basically set in the center. But another thing is that this is a variable speed when you use the trigger. And it's a very precise sander. You always want to be able to control your speed and your sanding with your palm lever itself. So I got my guide coat applied to my primer, and the reason I got a guide coat here is for one main reason, is to make sure and ensure that I sand the whole area that I prime. Another reason you would put a guide coat on is if you have major body work, you want to make sure that you use that guide coat, and this is for hand sanding, not with this. But you want to be able to block sand that out, and then the guide coat, if you have any imperfections or dents, they will show. It will remove everything but where the dent still is, or the crevice, or whatever you missed. But in this situation, we're using the guide coat to ensure that we sand everything. I'm going to go ahead and take my short throw sander. I got my 180 grit, and another thing I got, you can see it hanging, is my dust mask, very important. Let's go ahead and sand that. I'm going to show you how to save time and get her done right. Just done is I saved myself a considerable amount of time and also money. The reason why I have done this is because I used my short throw DA sander to finish the primer out, to feather all them edges out. It's not a paint ready finish yet. I still have to go back and I have to block sand it using my 400 wet sandpaper. But what I've done is I've saved me approximately 30, 40 minutes time and probably $5 or $6 in paint supplies, or should I say sandpaper supplies, by doing it this way. Now remember I was telling you, look what happened here. And we'll have to epoxy prime that before we paint it. But you can see, when you have a tape line, you have to feather that out. Now I tried to do it with the DA sander and it didn't work. So I'll have to hand sand that and feather that out. So it's really important to watch how you tape your vehicle off and to make sure that you tape it off the proper way. So what I'll do now is I'll give me a nice clean bucket of water. I'll go ahead and get me some brand new 400, wet sand 400 paper. I will block this whole hood down. I'm going to remove all the paper. I'll remove all the tape and paper, I'm sorry. And then I will sand this whole front clip using 400 and make it paint ready. But by using the DA technique, the dual action sander technique, there's my phone, I gotta go. You got the picture. This is Pete, my friend Pete, your friend Pete. Take it easy. I hope that trick helped you out. If you don't have a short throw sander, get one. You need it in this business. Southwest. Hello. What do you need, sir? Hello. All right. Okay. Take it easy. We'll see you later. This is Pete over at SWRNC DIY Auto School, helping people out. You can see what's going on here. I'm helping people buy junk cars. I'm fixing cars. I'm making a living, putting food on my table, and hopefully having fun doing it.
Watching DIY Automotive School. Classes don't stop till you know